Hello guys and welcome to the latest episode of Mr. Ashodi's Snapshot Science. Now in today's video, we're going to continue with homeostasis, but in particular we're going to focus on controlling the blood glucose level. Now hopefully by the end of this video, you're able to one, state the hormones involved in glucose regulation. We then want to go on to explain how blood glucose level is controlled, and finally we want to discuss type 1 diabetes. So don't go eating no sugary snacks, let's get right into it. Now guys, the control of blood glucose level is a very important concept in homeostasis. Remember we said homeostasis is keeping the internal conditions, internal environment constant. Okay? Now, cells need a steady supply of glucose because they use this glucose in respiration to release energy. Especially your brain. Your brain needs a steady and constant supply of glucose. If you have too much glucose, this can cause water to move out of your cells. Alright? Now if water leaves your cells, this might mean there's not enough water for metabolic reactions that are going to take place. So keeping blood glucose levels constant is very important, and it's part of homeostasis. Now, the control of blood glucose level is regulated by the pancreas and by the liver. Okay, so let's look at how the pancreas and liver are involved. Now you've previously looked at the pancreas, okay? You've looked at the fact that the pancreas is essentially two glands in one. And the pancreas makes pancreatic juice, which essentially flows along the pancreatic duct, okay, and is then released into the duodenum. Okay, you've learned about that. But the pancreas also has some very important cells. The pancreas has cells called islets of Langerhans. Okay? Now these islets of Langerhans produce two hormones, alright? And they are called insulin and glucagon. Now these hormones help the liver in controlling the blood glucose level. They help the liver keep the blood glucose level within a steady, narrow limit. Okay? Now, if we look at these hormones, insulin will lower the blood glucose level. Okay? Glucagon will raise the blood glucose level. Alright? Now, imagine you've just left your favourite mall, Villaggio. You've walked out with three Krispy Kremes donuts, and very quickly you've finished them all. This will cause your blood sugar level, your blood glucose level to rise, of course. Now what will happen, okay? The islets of Langerhans, remember we said these are cells within the pancreas, will detect the rise in blood sugar level. And this will cause, this detection of the rise in blood sugar level, okay, will cause the islets of Langerhans to secrete insulin. Okay, remember we said insulin brings the blood sugar level back down, okay? Now, the way that it does this is insulin causes the liver to absorb the glucose and convert this glucose into glycogen, okay? Why does it convert into glycogen? Because glycogen is an insoluble polysaccharide, all right? This glycogen is stored in the liver. So now there's less glucose flowing through the blood because it has been converted to glycogen and the glycogen is being stored in the liver. Alright? On the other hand, if the blood glucose level falls too low, okay, the pancreas will secrete glucagon. So when most of the glucose is gone, the pancreas secretes glucagon. Okay? And this glucagon causes the liver cells to break down the glycogen that they have been storing and release it and convert it back into glucose. Remember, glucose is a monosaccharide. Okay? And this glucose is released back into the blood and therefore the blood glucose level will rise again. Alright? Really important concepts. So let's look at this diagram. We'll start over here. You have a high blood glucose level after eating a high carbohydrate meal. The pancreas, okay, will secrete insulin. Now, insulin causes glucose to be converted into glycogen, okay? And this glycogen will be stored in the liver, all right? Insulin also causes the cells to take up the glucose and use it during respiration, and this also reduces the amount of glucose in the blood, okay? Now, let's imagine you have a low blood glucose level, okay? What will happen is the pancreas will produce and secrete glucagon. When most of the glucose is gone, glucagon is secreted. And this glucagon will cause the liver to break down the glycogen and break it down into glucose. And this glucose is secreted back into the blood so that the glucose level can rise again. Alright? So sketch this diagram, guys, just briefly so that you have it clear in your head. Now, when the natural control of glucose, okay, is not working properly, a person is said to have diabetes. Alright? Now, the death of the cells that secrete insulin, so the death of the islets of Langerhans, okay, causes type 1 diabetes. How do these cells die? It's thought to be due to the immune system actually attacking these cells. Okay? Now, this type of diabetes, type 1 diabetes, is usually developed when people are very, very young, okay? And so it's commonly diagnosed in children. Okay? Now, let's imagine you have type 1 diabetes. Hopefully you don't. Okay? If you have a high carbohydrate meal, this will cause the glucose concentration within the blood to rise. Okay? Just like everyone else. However, because you have type 1 diabetes, all right, the normal insulin secretion from the pancreas is not triggered. So what will happen, because there's not normal insulin secretion from the pancreas, alright, your blood glucose level, as it goes up, it will stay up, okay? And this is known as hyperglycemia. People who have hyperglycemia generally feel unwell. They will have dry mouth, they will feel thirsty, they will have blurred vision, and they will even have an increased heart rate and an increased breathing rate. Now let's imagine, okay, somebody who has type 1 diabetes. They haven't eaten carbohydrates for a long period of time, okay? Their blood glucose level will be very low. And what this will mean is that because they haven't been secreting insulin, because they have type 1 diabetes, it will mean there's no store of glycogen in the liver. Because there's no store of glycogen in the liver, okay, no glycogen, is turned into glucose to raise their blood sugar level back up. And this is known as hypoglycemia, okay? Now, people with hypoglycemia will tend to feel very tired, okay? They will suffer from confusion, irrational behavior, and unconsciousness even, okay? Now, blood glucose level, a person with blood glucose level, swinging from very high to very low, this can be dangerous because it can damage your organs. So people with type 1 diabetes try to keep their blood glucose within a narrow limit, okay? And they can do this by monitoring it. We're using a sensor and even a dipstick test to test their urine. So let's look at this dipstick test, okay? Urine, as you've looked at, the urine should not contain any glucose. But people with diabetes, if they have high sugar levels, all right, their blood sugar level, because it's very high, alright, what will happen is that the kidneys will be unable to reabsorb all of the glucose, alright, from the filtrate in the nephron. So because the sugar level, the glucose level is so high, the kidneys are unable to reabsorb all of the glucose from the filtrate in the nephron. Okay? And this will mean that some glucose will actually remain in the urine and be excreted from the body. Okay? So people with type 1 diabetes can tell if their sugar level is really high if they have glucose in their urine using a dipstick test. Okay? Now, finally, people with type 1 diabetes, okay, can manage their diabetes by injecting insulin. Okay, remember we said insulin will bring the blood glucose level back down by causing glucose to be stored in the liver as glycogen. This means that the liver has a glycogen store as well, okay, if the blood glucose level gets too low. But they can also manage their diabetes by eating little and often, this really helps, and also avoid eating large amounts of carbohydrates to avoid spikes in their blood glucose concentration, okay? So hopefully by the end of this video, you're able to state the hormones involved in glucose regulation. Hopefully you're also able to explain how glucose level is controlled. And finally, hopefully you're able to discuss type 1 diabetes. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe and revise. Mr. Ashodi signing out. Woof, I'm hungry. After Krispy Kremes.